Your feet are one of the most important things you have to protect, whether you're about to do marching band or drum corps. So, whether or not it's spring training time and you're about to move in with your favorite drum corps, or you're about to start marching band camp in the middle of July or August, this video is here to help you pick out the right utensils to put on your feet to protect them when it comes to this awesome marching art. Roll the intro. Welcome to Rocky Point Vlog, where it's my goal to help you by sharing my experiences throughout marching band, drum corps, and now high school band directing. There's a lot of them out there, and you may be swaying towards one brand that you really like or looks really cool, or maybe you have no idea what you want to wear at all for these marching arts. But I'm here to share my opinion. I also have my good buddy and a guy I marched with. He was my section leader at one point. He's just an overall around great guy. You've seen him on past Rocky Point episodes, Dan Pfeiffer.
Good morning, Rocky Point followers. It's good to be back.
So, spoiler alert, we both firmly agree on the same exact shoe brand, what you should be getting, and that brand is Asics. I've been wearing Asics exclusively to do all sorts of marching arts, everything, since my first summer with the cadets in 2013. When I happened to just buy them because I tested them out in the store. They were pretty cool. People on the internet seemed to sort of, you know, review them pretty good. And they had a rounded heel and gel, and they were blue. And I really just wanted to stand out in my favorite colors, blue. So, I thought they were different. I thought they were cool. Thought it was time for a change. And I heard really good things about Asics at the time. But I had no idea what I was getting myself into. So, I meet Dan that first year, and he's a really great guy. Really talented guy, really overall, like, overdoes things, like, he's awesome. So it turns out he wrote basically a paper about why Asics are the best marching shoe. I'm gonna let him talk a little bit about that, and then we're gonna get back to me and my tips, and then that'll wrap up the video. So here's Dan with a little bit about why Asics are the best marching shoe out there. Take it away, Dan.
I'm here today to talk for a brief few moments about shoes for drum corps. I wrote a dissertation, or quite a long little article a while back about what's good for your feet after a bunch of research. In my personal experience and situation, I found that a more rigid and durable shoe was a better fit for me in drum corps. Nike's never really quite worked. I'm not sure if Adidas would have worked at that point. I hadn't tried them, but Nike and Adidas tend to make much more flexible soles on their shoes, and I just personally found that that didn't help me. I had not the best arch support in my feet, and I needed something a little bit more durable. I did find Asics to be a fantastic fit for me. They are extremely durable shoes. They have a much more rigid sole, and they kind of bind your foot better to that sole with the lace structure. So it's a matter of personal preference, obviously, in some ways, but I would recommend getting something that's durable, has a sturdy sole. And a way of testing that is if you grab the toe of the shoe and pull it back towards the heel, it shouldn't bend excessively if you're looking for that firmer arch support, which I really think with the impact and repetitive nature of drum corps you need.
So when I try on my shoes in the store, what I like to do, or what I liked to do when I was marching in drum corps, or even marching band, but especially in drum corps, I wanted to make sure I had something that would last. I hate to break it to you, but those Nike Freeze, we had an experience with a friend of ours, Kyle, literally, that while they're great and you can feel the ground and it's nice in that way, but by the end of the season, I remember when he just like ripped them. And it works for some people. They sort of fall apart though, like most shoes. Asics are pretty well built. This is not a pair that I wore while I was marching. This is a pair I wear now when I'm running or I'm out doing stuff. And they're still pretty worn down. Like all these treads are gone. And, I firmly believe that these work. So I test out to make sure that the back edge, this might be okay. This is not my best I always liked a little more slant to it. Hopefully I can insert a picture here of what my shoes looked like when I did march drum corps. But a nice rounded heel so that you can get that nice roll step, assuming that's what your drum corps does, or it's not like 2035 and people are using jetpacks in drum corps now. It's also really important that, Asics, they have this gel, so that's really important. And that the toe slanted upward, because if the toe, like, where it went, like, completely flat, my toe would catch when you're trying to do, rolling down and then passing through and then doing another step in the technique. So really important that the toe dips up a little bit, or that this is flexible enough that it will eventually stay up like this shoe is right now, and that this is rounded. And then once you obviously march in them in the store, like all of us weirdo marching people do, you just make sure that they feel right for you. One thing that I personally didn't like was too much, like there's some pretty thick Asics shoes that honestly just felt too cushiony for the marching arts. I knew that once I put the actual like Dinkles or whatever brand of shoe your drum corps is wearing on, that they just didn't, they weren't as close together. Again, removing those variables, but again, you also want to protect your feet. So some other tips I have about protecting your feet in the marching arts, especially drum corps, is wear these as little as you possibly can. And I don't mean like go out and march in flip-flops, because that's a terrible idea. In the mornings we'd wake up, I remember when I was eager and young and a rookie, I would wear my tennis shoes from the dorms or wherever we were staying all the way out to eat breakfast, and then walk and sit at the day meeting, and then get started with the day. However, my feet were already sweaty and clammy by the time we got to that meeting. So what I quickly figured out everyone was doing and was the best option is, I took a carabiner, which looks like this, and I put it on my backpack, and I ran it through both of my shoelaces, made sure that they were tied so they don't fall off, so that I'd have them, and I'd stuff my pair of socks down in here really tight so that they wouldn't fall out, and then I'd wear them on my backpack to the day meeting while wearing flip-flops. I recommend Old Navy brand. Those are pretty rugged and they're cheap and they hold up really, really well, especially in a drum corps environment. And I'd wear those plasticky, not really fluffy, and they would, I'd wear those all the way up until the day meeting started. And while the day meeting was happening, not only would I put on sunscreen, I would switch shoes and clip the flip-flops to my backpack, and then of course put the tennis shoes on and be ready to go for the day. And then once ensemble or the day was over or rehearsal was over, I'd switch back into my flip-flops and clip my shoes back on and stuff my socks back in there. And then once I got back to the gym or wherever we were staying, I would throw the socks in the dirty laundry. And yeah, that's basically how I did it. Here's another tip that I figured out the hard way, again, my first season of drum corps, is about halfway through the season, I'd say July 1st was always my day after I figured this out. I always changed my insoles, and I always picked the Dr. Scholl's sports insoles and cut them properly after taking these insoles out. I basically put them up against it and traced them and cut them out and then stuck them in there. Super gel, super soft, and it prevented me from getting shin splints. Oftentimes that's why marching members have shin splints, is all that cushioning and things cause an excess of strain in the shins from especially all the toe stuff we do. So it's important that you change these once July 1st hits, if you moved in middle of May. At least that was my golden time, because I did have shin splints in one leg, actually. So I had a shin splint my first year in one leg, and it was not fun. Not a fun process. So avoid it at all costs. The other thing I wish I had done but never actually did was either waterproof my shoes using that waterproof spray. I think you have to reapply it every so often. I never did it, but again, that would really help on those rainy days. Those were the days that were awful in shoe land. Or something that came into the forefront of our minds towards my age out year were waterproof socks. I remember one of the Mellophones, Robert Machado, bought waterproof socks, and he completely bragged on them all the time, especially after a rainy rehearsal. Yeah, Andrew Denberg, waterproof tissues, and Robert Machado used waterproof socks. So I guess the choice is really up to you. Again, I've never done either of those, so I can't personally say they're guaranteed to work, but from my good friends, Yeah, they definitely help when you know it's going to rain. Or if your shoes are just waterproof, then I guess you're good either way. All of these things we've mentioned, from carabiners all the way through Old Navy flip-flops and waterproof socks and water repellent, all of that is gonna be linked in the description through my Amazon affiliate link. So not only will you get everything for the price that you want, anything you buy using those links will also help me out, help the channel out. So much appreciated. I've also linked the shoes that I have recommended down below. So again, links to all the products are in the description. Thank you for supporting the channel. We have a Patreon now if you're really feeling like you want to support us. Thank you to Dan for being on the show.
Great to be back on Rocky Point, and have a great summer, y'all.
Thank you to 8to5 Designs for this awesome Hi Mom shoe shirt, even though we don't recommend Nike Freeze and these are kind of based on Nike Freeze, but still it's a cool shirt. Hi Mom. I'll link to that in the description too. Sure, why not? In that store. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up because it really helps the YouTube algorithm to help get this marching art stuff out and recommend it to the right people. And share it with your friends, comment, and subscribe. I'm not saying you have to hit the notification bell, but that would be cool too, because I hear YouTube's having problems getting stuff out to people. So again, thank you for watching. We hope you've enjoyed, and until next time, we'll catch you guys later.